And we're back. How's it going? Coming to you today from a little bit cloudy Salt Lake City. And I want to talk to you about cheap people, skin flints. You know, someone so tight that they squeak when they walk. If they had a penny, they could pinch it so hard Abe Lincoln would cry. I can't think of any more metaphors except for just basically people who don't want to pay for anything. And I think I've said this already, if you're a person attempting to make any kind of money by being in your own business and you expect to get everything for free, quit now, because the only question is how fast you'll go broke, not whether or not you will, because you're done for. You cannot possibly be in business without making a profit, and you do not make a profit by giving everything away for free. Got it? All right. So what's got this thing bothering me today? Did my girl Rocket, who is freaking awesome, which is why she's called Rocket, has an eBay store and she sells stuff online as well as being my partner in business. For instance, what happened today, someone sends her a message about a purse she's got online. Now, when Rocket sells a bag, a lot of times it'll be Louis Vuitton or Hermes or Chanel. I don't even know these names, the designer names. And these bags can cost $1,000-$2,000. And she gets them and sells them online. So say it's a $500 bag and she'll sell it for maybe $200 or $300, whatever. And this particular bag, I have no idea how much it was worth or who made it, but she had it on there for $70. And this person sends her a message that she wants to make her an offer on the bag of $35 or $30. And I'm thinking to myself, no. And of course, Rocket said, no, you don't get stuff for free. This is, are you kidding me? Basically. And what gets me about the whole situation is you see these motards walking around with their freaking signs, waving them, talking about the 1% and how they got all the money and everything. Well, let me give you a quick reality check. If you were born in the United States of America, you are globally one of the 1%. You are so rich compared to the rest of the world. It's insane. And if you don't have anything in your bank account, it's because of your lack of ability to produce. Period. End of story. We're done. I don't care where you were born, where you come from, who left you what. It doesn't matter. There are people who had it far worse than I and who have exceeded what I will ever achieve in my lifetime. I don't feel bad about that. I cheer them on. I'm like, damn, thank God for people like you who can build a phone that I can pay $1,000 for, hold it in my hand, and speak to tens of thousands of people every single day at such a cheap price. It's unfathomable to me, these people who expect everything for free. No, you don't just automatically get a color television and a car and a two-car garage and a four-bedroom house simply because you're breathing the same air that I am. You got to go out and you got to produce and get people to give you money, and then you'll be able to have stuff. Okay, that includes your freaking health care or anything else that you think ought to be free. Someone's got to pay for it one way or another. And hey, why not you? Why don't you become rich so that you can buy stuff for everybody else? Sometimes it gets a little bit aggravational to me because I see a lot of people. They're collecting stuff for nothing. Now, don't get me wrong. You can't just kick those people to the curb who can't produce for themselves. There might be people that'll never be able to hold a job. Well, you can't just ignore those people. I get that. But come on now. If you've got two good arms and legs and a reasonable, for instance, if you're smart enough to get on YouTube and watch this or wherever you found it, then you can make a living, a damn good living. You'll probably do better than me or most of the other people around you because you've taken that initiative to get something going on. But for crying out loud, if you expect to get anywhere in the world, someone is going to have to pay you for your production. And if you believe that everybody should give you money for free, the same thing must hold true for them. So who's going to produce all this money that everybody's getting for free? Without getting into the economics of the Federal Reserve and all that, let's leave that alone. But for now, if you're not going to Walmart, throwing a toaster up on the counter that's for $20 and offering them $10, then don't do that to the people, your brothers and sisters who are out here trying to make a living just like you and stick it to the man just like you. When you go ahead and bitch about all the rich people, and yet you'll throw money at them, whatever they ask, anytime they ask. Does that make any sense to you? So from now on, let's get this right. It's us, me and you and everybody else, against the man. We have to stick together. And that means producing. That's all I got for today. I'll talk to you tomorrow.